Hi guys, hello! How's it going?
It's table one.
What's up in the house? We try.
Yeah, we try, my ladies.
You having a good time so far?
It's great.
Yeah.
It's great. Who are we kidding? I mean, the fact that we came back, we were so surprised. I think James knew about it for a while, but they've been trying to work it out. Like, oh, we definitely know the movie's happening. Let's try to get into Comic-Con. None of us knew about it. So when we were working on it, and they're like, so, do you want to go to Comic-Con? And I'm like, A, like we have a choice. B, like anyone would ever say no. And then was anybody here, were you guys at the panel? Was anybody here at the panel?
I was
handful. Okay, so there's probably... We were so nervous when they told us where we were going to be, because we're like, oh, we haven't been to Comic-Con for 4 years, and the show's been on for 3 years, so, you know, maybe put us in one of these, like, max occupancies of 400 people, and that'll be great. It'll be fun. And they're like, no, you're lower than 20, I'm like,
don't tell for yourself.
No, gosh.
And the line was out the door.
You guys have a huge...
I was afraid I wouldn't get in, honestly. Like,
We didn't expect it at all. Even on the, you know, they pick us up in vans and they shuttle our shuttles and they shuttle us over to the hotels. And we're like, guys, I don't know.
I don't know if they put us in ballroom 20.
But it, so that was a wonderful surprise.
And not too shabby.
Backstage, we're like, oh wow, this is still happening. And that's something I think all of us were really surprised at, because, what, 3 years we've been on the air now? And nobody's really lost fans. If anything, like, people are rediscovering it or discovering it for the first time, like those 13-year-olds are like,
oh, yeah,
I just found out about this new show! And I'm like,
whoa. Yeah, Netflix.
We're nobody tell, you know?
It's like, we're all like,
keep that campaign alive, right? I think it has something to do with Netflix and with USA Network.
Yeah.
So, keep getting that out there.
You gotta rewatch it for the movie.
You gotta rewatch that season. Yeah. And people are tweeting pictures of, I got my DVD box set. I'm like, oh, good, DVDs are still being made, you know? So they can still do that. So, I guess that was like this huge surprise. So that helped convince the executives to say, oh, well, maybe there is still life in this fun
show. So did we learn anything new about the
that I can tell you. That's the key phrase there, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, we will learn something new about Chief. And because everybody's up in San Francisco now. So I'm in charge of a much bigger department. Sean, in this movie, takes a case on his own. So this is not an FPD sanctioned case, but I think you learn very quickly in this group that if you mess with one of us, you mess with all of us. Which I think was a great shot, the one that they did decide to release to the first look shot, the entertainment of all of us on the front and top, that you saw in the first, in the trailer, down in the hall. So we're back at those docks. Of just, it doesn't matter if you messed with Sean, it doesn't matter if you messed with Juliet, or even with Woody, because he's there too. Not only is Woody there, I had to hire him in San Francisco as well. I was just like, how do we get everybody up here? Well, I guess we gotta hire him. And it's great because he's part of, again, the coroner staff, and this coroner hates him. Like, he's such a fool. And she's great. She's great. So, we learned a little bit about me. We might learn a little bit about, is my family still involved?
Actually, you have a husband and child.
I did have a husband and child. She's got like an Emmy.
She's a little busy.
We can only fit so much into our, like, you know, 90 pages, but I had hoped that she would be brought back but time commitments couldn't allow it. Like Kurt Smith, who wanted to come back as well. But he's like touring. He's in a little band called Tears for Fears. And they're like on a big tour now. So no, we don't get to see my sister. But I don't know about the rest of my family.
And you got to work with Zachary Levi a little bit. How was that? You finally got him?
We finally got him. And I thought the connection was always with James. And the connection with Zach was too late. And I was like, what? I'm sure these two big nerds. I mean, I guess I should call him James a nerd. He's a nerd. The James and Zach were the connection. But the fact we got him this time, he was wonderful. He's crazy. Absolutely crazy in this character. It's just delightful. He's just so he's the one that decides to mess with us.
What is he doing? Are you lurking?
No, I was actually trying to find a ride to the
hotel. Oh, no, you gotta walk. It's so much easier to walk back to the hotel. Put your shades on, put your hat low, because you're Corbin Burns. Swap hats with him and see what happens.
Oh, Zach would be on the show. I'd like spot the pineapple.
Spot the pineapple. And then there it is. And I don't even remember when the pineapple pops up in this episode, because obviously they had to put it in.
We were told that we cannot possibly kiss him. Yes.
Oh, I know where it is. No, you're not going to be able to miss it. No, it's just going to be so. Well, again, I'd have to kill you if I told you that. That's awkward, because I like your hat. But there's, we've got some big surprise guest stars, and yes, it is with that guest star.
So, I'm going to fangirl for a moment. You're my biggest role model growing up. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So, when you were, like, the chief, were you written that strong? Or did you kind of bring in and be like, no, she's going to be a badass?
I think probably a little bit of both. I didn't, when they cast me, obviously it's the actor that walks into the room like, oh, I like that vibe. But I was 5 months pregnant when I did the pilot, and I was only going to get bigger. They were like, let's cast you in August. And I was like, listen, bye. And we shot in November, and my baby was born in January. So I'm like, this is just going to keep going. So I think it was a little bit of, they love, everybody had seen Fargo by that point. Frances McDormand as pregnant police chief was already there. And I wanted to make sure that she wasn't just a woman in power, she just was the chief. That, which is kind of nice sometimes with a police system, a military system, is that it's rank. And there is no insubordination to rank. It's not about being a woman, it's not being a man, but it's the just art. And what came with that was me. And I think that we kind of worked a symbiotic relationship of, yeah, that's who she is.
Guys, we're going to wrap now. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.